today's video, we're gonna review Tammy's lawsuit situation. She's filing against the magistrate judge for trying to help the other judge who is being sued for giving her judgment to the attorney she already paid. Tammy got some drama going on. So we're gonna in this video, this is how we're handling the magistrate judge who interfered without the consent form being signed, and we found out there's some other problems. We'll get to those. But before we start, I want to make sure that you guys know. Okay, don't hit me up. I need your help. I need you to do this for me. Tammy did this herself. Okay, she did this herself. I want to be clear. She's the badass here because she forced them to award her judgment with an attorney she hired running interference the entire time. And I don't know how long this took because you guys know how I am when I'm helping people do things. I don't really know I don't want to know all of that stuff because you guys are the ones that I got to make decisions. I need to know what I need to know. So Tammy's situation, this is considered a special project for me and her. And I saw Tammy's story on Facebook and basically she wanted a judgment and the judge used the statute to give the rest of her money to her attorney that she already paid. So, yeah, y'all know I don't have a problem with that. And so Tammy and I sat down, I hit her up. And it took a couple of days because they were punching her pretty bad. And she finally, her and Ray got to talking. They figured it out. She's in a different position right now. And we're going to talk about that today. So this is a special project. I don't do this all the time for everybody. This is a special project. Tammy had already been awarded her judgment. And they took it from her. All of it. Yeah, they took all of it. And so Tammy and I sat down and then we figured out, what the value that would need to be there for both of us to be able to do this together. Basically, I'm coaching her. She's doing it. Y'all know how I roll. I don't do nothing. I just hide out in this. entertainment. So tonight we're kind of going to roast a new judge, okay? Judge Annie T. Christoff. She goes by, her name also is Marvel and Tower. And she goes one or two other names. I don't understand why judges need to have so many names. Judge Kopecky had 6 or 7, I think. And I haven't had a chance to look up those names to see what he been up to. Yeah, because those names represent something. Anyway, so we got a new judge on the grill, and I think we might have to have a new playlist, with judges on the grill at some point in time, because when they interfere with the people in our ring, it's going to be a problem because we are learning how to challenge their stuff according to their rules. As long as you can trump the crap they're bringing to the table, you don't have to answer to them. Just keep punching them. Now, just to be clear, I would only consider if I decide to do this as a service, I would only consider accepting special projects like Tammy's if the judgment was awarded and the players conspired to take everything in the end. And yeah, I got her in my head. Okay, let me stay focused. Now Tammy's lining herself up to sue the magistrate judge for violating her due process. Yep, the magistrate judge took jurisdiction without the signed consent form. So that's the situation that we have right now. And one of the things, in the conventional program, it's easy for them to convince, let me get you over to the real judge. Let me get you to the big judge. I'm going to send you to the heavenly. No. Once the magistrate judge violates you, what? You're going to go with his boss? Well, that judge's boss sent your ass down there in the first place, and the clerk didn't fill out the consent form that the judge needs to be in your face in the first place. So that's where we started with this situation, and then we it's getting ugly. But not for Tammy. So Tammy filed her case in the Western District of Tennessee. And that's Rudd versus Mays, R-U-D-D versus M-A-Y-S, case number 2/23, CV 02721-. I'll open the information to her case in the comment section. And I'm hoping she's going to send email me the complete document, a PDF of the complete document, so that I can post it in a blog so that everybody can see it. Now, Tammy won in federal court, and then the judgment was appealed to the Sixth Circuit Court, Ohio, and the verdict was never overturned. Statute. The judge used a statute to give the remainder of Tammy's judgment to the attorney that she already paid. Yeah, I wonder how many times this is going on around her. The paid lawyer resigned early and threw Tammy under the bus. The attorney told Tammy that she lost. Judge Samuel H. Mays, M-A-Y-S, signed the judgment to the lawyers in an administrative process. Administrative court process. Now, the problem now is that magistrate judge Annie T. Christoff took jurisdiction without the consent form being signed by our parties as mandated by 28 U.S.C. section 636C and the Federal Rules of Civil Procedure 73. Now, if you do your homework, you'll find out that that consent form needs to be signed to give the magistrate judge, who is a lesser judge, the magistrate judge is supposed to be taking the trash out for the other judge. So that's violated. So instead of going back and letting the other judge come back and violate you again or whatever, we're just going straight to the So now the magistrate judge is on the hook for trying to help. Judge Annie T. Christoff had no jurisdiction or grounds to order a show cause hearing without consent from all parties. Now, I'm going to show you guys some information about the show cause hearing. And the research is going to show that Marvell and Tower did not file the customary, Judge Christoff, I didn't know what, there's several, Marvell, A. Tower, Fremont, I didn't know, I'm not sure which are the names I'm supposed to refer to Judge Witz when there's so many different names. But anyway, we'll just call her Judge from now on. And she did not file the customary affidavit required for a defendant to demand the show cause hearing. As a matter of fact, the defendants never did answer. So the legal team is in the opinion that I'm just reporting this. Okay, so if there's anything wrong, let me know. We'll get it corrected. But the legal team has pointed out the fact that the management judge, Judge Christoff, is representing her fellow bar members by answering to the plaintiff's lawsuit with her unlawful order to show cause. And we're gonna show some facts later and let you guys decide yourself if this is dirty. And I'm wondering, did all of Judge Christoff's cases, did she have any of the consent forms signed? Did the clerk have any of the consent forms signed before the judge, because the judge didn't have time to check? I don't know if the judge didn't have the consent form signed for any of her cases, then I think they all should be called up for a judicial review, starting with the plaintiff's case. I don't know. I'm just thinking. Now, the reason the judge demanded the show cause hearing was the judge lied and said the green card verifying service was missing. And maybe it was missing to her. Maybe the clerk had it. I don't know. But the green card had been, yeah. So, you know, that's really neither here nor there. What I do know is that if the process of service was not perfect, there would be no cause for a show cause hearing. So we're going to take a look at a few things. The first thing I want to take a look at is what a show cause hearing is. And then we're gonna find out who Judge Christoff is, with the other several names. So I'm going to do a screen share here. This is the consent form that the clerk, according to their policy, is supposed to have filled out and signed. It's a little big there. By all parties. And you can Google this consent, magistrate judge consent form, and then put your state in there. And you can pull that up. So it says right in there that right here that that this is what they're in accordance with. Well, they didn't follow this because they didn't get it signed like they were supposed to. Now, you know, I play football and I box, and so I like to keep things simple and not, because those are things two things people do that aren't that smart. So I like to keep it simple. If they don't follow their policies and procedures, the whole process becomes unfair for you, right? And so that's a violation of your due process. Keep it simple. Don't make it all complicated and all that. You know, once they violate their own law, federal rules of procedure, and So let's just move on and take a look at a show cause order. What in the hell is that? And so right here, you know, and like you need to remember when you're looking up this stuff, the first pages that you come to are not the ones. And a lot of times anything looks like an attorney's page is not the one. And you can see this is just an advertisement or somebody else's stuff. But the fire is here. So, in a legal system, an order to show cause is a court order requiring an individual or entity to explain, justify, or prove something. In U.S. court, frequently the order is used to initiate a court proceedings that needs to be heard outside of a usual schedule. Oh. Such as temporary order being sought. And in these cases, the court needs additional information. The judge could make a decision to explore this concept and consider the following show cause. Let's take a look at the order to show cause definition. Definition of order to show cause. So an order to show cause. Order that's a party to specify date and time and reasons to show cause why the order requesting the opposite party to. So an order requested by the opposing party should be made. So the opposing party is supposed to order this. I don't know. That's what it says here. Not the judge. The opposing party never answered. So it appears the judge is answering for the opposing party. Would that be practicing law from the bench? I think that's a no-no. I don't know. Let's just go on. I don't want to assume anything. So what is order to show cause? Order to show cause is used in place of a motion in circumstances that require immediate solution. Where the motion starts the parties on equal footing. As far as the courts are concerned, the order to show cause requests that the court make a decision ordering the other party to appear and provide information and evidence as why the order should not be made. Oh, wait a minute. It says that, request that the court make a decision ordering. So who's supposed to? Thoughts are part of the orders to show cause are temporarily used as. Okay, so what is the difference between order to show cause and a motion? How do you get an order to show cause? Let's just get right over to that. So the rule of procedure outlines strict requirements to make a motion through individuals seeking immediate relief may find it easier to complete and file an order to show cause at the clerk's office. Order to show cause requires the identity of all parties to the case and the case number and the court. Show cause order must contain the request made or relief sought by the person filing it. In this case, it's the judge. And the show cause order must be accompanied by an affidavit in support of the order to show cause. This affidavit is a detailed statement of the circumstances that make it necessary for the filing party to obtain the quick order. Supporting documents may be attached to the to show cause is missing the necessary affidavit to support it in a judicial court because Judge Annie T. Christoff moved the plaintiff is trying to move the plaintiff's case over into the administrative court. So let's just take a look and peek at Judge Annie T. Christoff. Oh, here we go. That's what I'm looking for. I'm trying to zoom in. Judge Annie T. Christoff. So this is her profile for the Tennessee Bar Association, the same association that the defendants belong to. So, you know, that's interesting. We just want to share that. Let's see what else that we found out about Miss Annie. Oh, yep, there's her name again. Annie T. Associate Attorney. So she's Associate Attorney for this law firm. Consults with people on lawyers. Wonder if she could have a conflict of interest. Could she have a conflict of interest? I don't know. I'm sure you guys would trust her to make a decision for you if you were suing the bar members. I'm sure you would trust her to rule over your case if you were suing her. That's her being sworn in as a judge. I'm sure you would trust her. To be fair, I don't know. I don't know. But anyway, she's got, is that her right or left hand? Okay, sorry. I'm sure you would trust her, to be fair. I didn't know. Oh, here's some more. Here she works for a law firm, Brassberry and Sim. So I wonder if the defendants work with her in the past or work with her in the present. Or if they have cases in her court already that they're throwing other people under the bus. I don't know. I just wonder. Yeah, there was some of her aliases. That's interesting. Clearly the magistrate judge has stepped outside of the rules and what they're supposed to be doing to assist, it appears, to the plaintiff and to the plaintiff's legal team that Judge Christoff has made an attempt to assist her fellow bar members, which placed herself in the path of civil liability. And I think the plaintiff's legal team is getting ready to address that. Now, this is how you handle the magistrate judge being involved in your face. Okay, you just straight out figure out, yep, and do something about it. This is how, if you don't do something about it, the minute they step up, they'll keep punching you in the face. And what they're trying to do with Tammy is get her over in the administrative side, to contract with her to get her agree to do the administrative crap over there, so when the judge can come up with stupid shit to so they can eventually throw her dismissal shit like they did before. But that's not the way things are going down this time. So Tammy's taking care of business. I think she's going to recuse the judge now. She filed her demand to strike the judge's order, and she outlined in that demand that the judge is in violation of foreign Agent Registration Act, which is a federal law, and it's called FARA. The judge is also in violation of a bunch of other stuff. It's pretty intense, and so we're getting ready to Tammy's getting ready to file her lawsuit in state court because she can't get anything done over there with these people's friends or whatever. About to get hot in the kitchen, and we got another judge on the grill. So So we're gonna keep you guys up to date on what's going on as long as we can, and that's all we got to say about that. Now you guys see how we do this, so you can do it yourself, and that's the beauty of running in this program, is you learn how to do it yourself. Bam, there you go. Thank you guys for the value of sharing your time, and I'll see you in the next video.